Hello, I'm Dr. Erin Longbrake, an assistant professor of neurology at Yale University. My research is focused on multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis is the most common cause of neurologic disability among otherwise young, healthy individuals. The most recent estimates place the number of affected Americans at nearly 1 million, including such well-known figures as Ann Romney, Jack Osborne, and Selma Blair. MS can strike at any aspect of the central nervous system, robbing its victims of their sight, their ability to walk, or their ability to feel a loved one's touch at a moment's notice. The disease is unpredictable. It can relapse at any time, and the damage it causes to the brain is irreversible. It's also an incredibly expensive disease, with an estimated lifetime cost of over $4 million per patient, and for the US, an estimated cost of $28 billion per year. At its heart, MS is caused by an immune system that's gone astray. Instead of protecting the body from germs, the MS immune system seeks and destroys parts of the nervous system. Early treatment of MS is key to preventing disability and allowing affected individuals to stay in the workforce and continue living the lives they want. Yet, even at the first symptoms of MS, brain damage has already happened, and the immune system has already become derailed in 100 different ways. My research is aimed at pushing the diagnosis of MS even earlier in the disease process and preventing long-term consequences of the disease. I am the principal investigator of a clinical trial studying whether short-term immune suppression is sufficient to prevent MS if it's given early enough in the pathologic process. As part of this work, I'm collaborating with basic scientists and bioinformaticians to discover biomarkers that let us recognize the very first signs of an immune system gone awry. My training as a physician scientist has been invaluable to these efforts. Because I am a physician, I understand which clinical questions are most imperative to address, and I have the tools to design effective clinical trials and recruit the correct group of patients. Because I'm also a scientist, I have a deep understanding about the work that's going on in the basic laboratories, and I can make sure my collaborators get the right samples at the right time from the right patients. At times, basic scientists and medical doctors can speak very different languages, and having individuals with multidisciplinary training is key to identifying and bridging gaps in communication so that the most transformative science can emerge. It is incredibly important that the United States continue to support and increase support for physician scientists. These individuals don't come out of nowhere. Each physician scientist represents one of our nation's brightest and most committed individuals who has already poured dozens of years of their lives into research and training. They are integral members to cross-disciplinary translational research teams, and they cannot be replaced easily. We look forward to ongoing conversations about ways to reinforce and increase support for physician scientists. Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to watch our video, and thank you for your continued support of physician scientists. To write your senator or representative, please go to this link. Below the main message, please write, "Increase support for physician scientists, bridge funding and grants." Thank you.